starting. Kind of trip out of getting coming out of here. See if I remember how to get in there.
Presidential Boulevard using the left lane.
Thank you.
zone kind of too.
Austin.
My name is Chris. I'll be your driver. I'm recording for our safety.
Please use your seatbelt for your safety.
How was your flight?
It's easy.
The people I just dropped off are going to Australia. They're going back home to Australia.
Mile, make a slight left turn on Presidential Boulevard.
Yeah, they said 17 hours.
Yeah,
but they're going to Dallas then from there.
Okay. Is that a direct flight from Dallas?
Yeah, I think so. But they say they lose a day when they go back.
That's probably, yeah, you cross the main line.
Yeah.
A friend of mine studied abroad in China for a year, and he said it was weird flying home because...
It's like you're missing a whole day, right?
Well, I day and a half. Was coming back or going, but I guess it was coming back. He said, you know, you take off, you fly for 13 hours, and you land an hour later or something.
Yeah. Yeah, but going home is what gets you though.
Make a slight left turn on Presidential Boulevard.
Northbound going east to west is easier because I'll have like one night where I'm tired and I go to bed early, but then pretty quickly get back on.
Yeah, the jet lag's worse going from west to east, right?
Yeah, west to east. I'm staying up late.
Just ahead, keep right using the right lane.
Yeah, when it rained Monday night.
A quarter mile, keep left to stay on Presidential Boulevard using the left lane.
It brought the coldness with you.
It's not usually this warm in Massachusetts in November.
Yeah, well, the big wigs don't want to believe in climate
keep
change.
Left to stay
so.
On Presidential Boulevard.
Yeah. Yeah, they don't.
I don't know why. What's so hard to believe about it?
Pockets being lined by.
Yeah, but you can't take it with you.
So they care, I guess. But I'm with you. Can't take it with you, and you're leaving something worse for the next generation.
You gotta live with yourself at the end of the day, you know. That's how I think.
Yeah.
So if you're raised with no morals, what do you care?
It's true. Can I go home at night and look myself in the mirror?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, we'll see how these next 4 years are gonna be.
Oh my gosh. I don't know if I'm more like numb or filled with rage. Like which end of the spectrum I'm on right now.
It's just weird, man, how more than half of the people will leave somebody like that.
Using the left lane, turn left on Highway 71 East.
He just tries to control the narrative, just like he was saying the people in Philadelphia were cheating. He was saying that yesterday. I'm like, cheating how?
Just ahead, continue on Highway.
He just tries to plant that seed so when it doesn't come out his way. But she should
have.
I don't know. I went to sleep when I figured out she wasn't going to win.
Oh, I know. When Virginia wasn't close, or was close, I was like, yeah, I'm not going to stay up and watch this happen. I'll find out in the morning. Part of the East Coast, because you start finding out things so late that it's such a late night. Versus my brother in California.
It's crazy, man. I didn't know there was that many people in the country. In the rural areas.
Right. This is what I'm going to say every time someone says we shouldn't have a popular vote because only the cities will decide. I'm like, oh, really?
Yeah, well, what's more important? Who brings the money?
US Highway 183.
Cities, right?
Exactly.
Well, I think he won popular vote anyway, so.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see when California comes in. I think they're going to take a while to count their votes. But right now, it's
okay. I don't understand how the founding forefathers thought it was just going to be 13 colonies and that was it.
Keep right onto US Highway 183 North.
I don't know. It's just the future. Well, the history will tell the tale of what happened.
Yeah. I was telling my of living through unprecedented times. It's getting really old. Could deal with some nice boring years.
Yeah.
Nothing much happens.
Well, I think for here on out, it's like something's always going to happen, so. I don't even live in Austin. I drive from San Antonio over here.
Oh,
It takes about an hour, a little over an hour.
Okay. How long have you lived in San Antonio?
A little over 2 years. I don't like it. I didn't grow up there. That's the only reason why.
Take right onto Texas 111 loop.
Where did you grow up?
In Houston.
Yeah, those two cities feel very different.
What, San Antonio and Houston?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. I don't see why anybody goes to San Antonio. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just I didn't grow up there, so.
Yeah. You gonna move back?
Yeah. Me and my little brother planning on moving back. And, but I gotta see how it is over there. I haven't. Because it takes. I gotta get that adaptable charger for that. Because, there's not many charging stations I could plug into between San Antonio and Houston.
Yeah, that's
so it's like a because it's like 200 miles.
Yeah.
And this could do 200 miles, but it'd be right on the edge of am I gonna make it or not? And
yeah, I have an EV too. Like, you gotta plan your route.
Yeah. What kind you have?
Just ahead, keep left on East 7th Street using the left lane.
How you like it?
Well, I bought it off of a family member, so.
Keep left on East 7th Street.
How many miles it had on it?
56,000 when I bought it from them.
Using the right lane, continue straight to stay on East 7th Street.
I really like driving it. It's a lot of fun to drive.
Yeah.
It's just, getting used to, like, keeping charging in mind.
Well, it's easier if you have a garage and plug it in.
Yeah, and I don't have an actual EV charger at home yet, so I just have a regular outlet. So, like, it works. I have a charger that can plug into it, but it's slow.
Oh, yeah, that's going to take all day, right?
Yeah, I mean, overnight I'll gain, like, 20%.
Oh, man.
Which, like, if you're not driving much, it's
fine. That's the regular plug, right?
Yeah.
Like the plug for this right here? It's a plug right here.
Yes. Yep. But I'm in a condo, so I have to get approval before I can install an actual EV charger. Hopefully soon.
But the supercharger charges it up how fast?
Real fast. Depend up where I am. Like, it'll charge faster in the warmer months than in the winter because the battery gets
cold. That's crazy,
it
huh?
It takes longer.
Did your relative tell you all that before you bought it?
Yeah, no, I bought the car for my dad, he told me.
Oh, your dad didn't like it?
No, he got a different car.
Another EV or not?
Another EV, yeah. He has charging at home, so for him it's easy.
What kind of EV did he get?
He got the new Model 3. Mm-hmm. It got newer features that he wanted. And I guess Tesla's sales were not so great over the summer, so they threw out all these incentives and people bought one, so mm-hmm. It was like, I mean, I can buy one and it's not that much.
Isn't it kind of bumpy though? I rode in a Tesla a couple of times. I feel like you feel every bump on the road.
I haven't noticed that, but I also, like, the car that I had before this one, very bumpy. So.
What kind of car was it?
That was a Hyundai Accent.
Was it it's the little beauty one, right? It's the industrial plants that's making all the pollution. Cars are making some, but.
Figure every little bit helps.
Yeah. But what about China? China's messing it up. Russia's messing it up.
Like what we were saying before, if I could go home and look myself in the mirror at the end of the day.
Yeah.
I did what I could.
I'm good.
Drive up to Austin to do Uber because, like, the rides are better.
Yeah, it's more money out here. I don't do the Uber eggs. So I just put the Comfort in the Premier Rides. And over there, if I just... Because I rode around with just the Comfort, the Premier. I'm already driving around 15 minutes. I'm like, nah, I got to turn the Uber eggs on. Because I got to at least make some money if I'm out here.
Yeah.
So I said, I'll just drive over here. And it's more consistent on the Comfort and the Premier Rides. There's been a couple of them from San Antonio to over here 2 times, and from San Antonio to Uvalde one time. That's when I was kind of because at least over here they got chargers over here, but
in a quarter mile
over there Uvalde is like eight, but I just had charged up the car. It was a different car. I just had charged it up, so I made it back. I made it back with with 20 miles. Oof. So I was like, there's no charger out there in Uvalde. People who got the EVs, I guess they charge them at home, you know.
Turn left on Chicon Street.
Yeah, so about 80 miles. 2 times up from San Antonio to over here, and 1 time from San Antonio to Uvalde. But I don't get paid to drive back. I just get paid to drop off.
You know? Yeah, that's where you gotta, like, anyone going to San Antonio? Yeah. Request a ride now.
Yeah, and it was only like what? It was like a $40, $45 trip. And I gotta go 80 miles on Uber X. So I told him, it was a youngster. I told him, man, you know, I usually wouldn't do this, man. But I already accepted it, and I just charged up, so. But he tipped me like about, it ended up being about $80 total. So, but like I said, that is only paying me to go over there. I gotta drive back. I told me anybody else wouldn't have taken that ride. Not for no $41 doing 80 miles. You got to come 80 miles back. That's 160 miles for $40. And you're not guaranteed to get a tip, so.
How many days a week do you do this?
Well, I usually try to go every day, but I didn't. But Monday, I was going to come back over here, but it rained. You know, I seen that it was going to rain because, you know, I was looking at the weather to. Cause it looked like it was gonna rain, so I didn't want to drive over here when it was pouring down rain.
Yeah.
And then I'm not very familiar with the area, so it's harder to see during the rain. And
yeah.
Then yesterday I was gonna come over here. I said, man, let me see how this election. Cause it took us about an hour and a half. Me and my brother, we went to go vote at the library. It took about an hour and a half. Now I'm like, man, why did I even waste my time?
No, it's always always important.
Yeah, but when you vote blue in a red state or vote red in a blue state, it doesn't matter. Your vote don't matter. So. Is it right here on the right hand?
Yeah.
Right in here?
Yeah. Yes, this.
The door you go in right there? No, it's some smoothies and smiles.
Down there.
Or more down here? Alright. Turn in here?
I'll figure it out. I can ask the valet where to go.
Alright, well, let me back it up a little bit then. Good day, ma'am.
You too.
Thank you. 8.5 hours. So that's 3.5 hours. Gone. $6.10, $1.30 in 3.5 hours. That's 35. No, yeah, almost 35. Seeing 130 miles. Attention, away. Waymo. restroom in here. Pause it, y'all. Motherfucker said restroom not working. So go around, swing around to that target. There's a target around there. I was gonna pull right there, but nothing. You get in? Yes, sir. name's Chris. I'll be your driver. I'm recorded for our safety.
Yep.
Here at the right?
Yeah.
Enjoy the rest of your day, sir.
You too. Thank you.
Thank you.
Trinity Street.
my hair dry. I'm gonna get a haircut tomorrow. Hello.
Hi.
Hello.
¿No traes otro?
Perilimo, right? Perilimo?
Guillermo, yeah.
11. Have a good day. Thank you. Bye. You're welcome. Clip, y'all.